Vidu's reference to video feature might be the most consistent character generations I've ever seen from an AI video generator. In this video, I'm going to take you through how it works, and we'll see if it holds up across realistic portraits, animated characters, animals, or even merchandise. Let's get started. Let's head to Vidu.studio and sign in. On the Vidu dashboard, you'll see three ways to create videos: image to video, reference to video, and text to video. If you have used AI video tools before, you might be familiar with the image to video and text to video options. Text to video lets you type out a description of the scene and it will turn it into a video. The image to video option lets you use an image as the starting point for generating the rest of the video. But today we'll focus on Vidu's reference to video features to show you how to keep characters or objects looking the same throughout your video. On the reference to video tab, the first step is to upload your character. For this example, I'm using a realistic character I created on Midjourney. Once the image is uploaded, you can select specific parts of the character to ensure consistency of the selected area. If you want to reference the whole image, you probably don't have to specify here. But I want to try focusing on keeping the hairstyle, her face, and maybe some parts of her clothes as well. So let's put a box around her like this and see what happens. In the description, you'll need to identify your character with a straightforward label, such as in here. I'll use a beautiful Asian woman to describe her. According to Vidu's prompt guide, a good prompt structure typically includes elements like the subject, scene, environment, and artistic style or medium. But if you want to keep it simple, you can think in terms of the what, where, when, and how of your video. So for my prompt, what is a beautiful Asian woman is reading a book, and where is at a coffee shop, when is in a golden hour, which is said to be the best time for photography, and how is low angle shot, depth of field effect, shot with Sony FX6 camera, warm and cozy vibe. I am not sure if the training involved all these, but I'm just trying. This is just an easy prompt structure that I use to quickly create detailed prompt without overcomplicating the process. But if you want more tips on crafting effective prompts in Vidu, you can click on guide for more detailed prompting. We'll leave the enhanced prompt option on so Vidu can optimize the prompt to improve the results. If you want more control and less creativity from the AI, you can also check it off. For video duration, we have options for 4-second or 8-second clips. But we'll need to upgrade to a paid plan to generate a 8-second video. As for generation mode, we're sticking with the default speed option. If you upgrade to the advanced plan, you can use the quality mode, which supposedly give better results, but I didn't upgrade, so we'll skip this. Let me know how it is if you've tried. Alright, let's hit that create button. So making one 4-second video costs 4 credits. 8-second video costs 8 credits. Free users get 80 credits each month. If you need more, pay plans start at $7.99, giving you extra credits and commercial use rights. Before I could even finish talking, our video is ready. It usually takes about 30 to 60 seconds to generate a video. This makes a video probably the fastest AI video generator out there. The trade-off is that the initial video is low resolution at 688 by 384p, just to give you a preview. But you can upscale to 1080p right here on the platform if you like what you see. And the frame rate would go from 16 to 24 frames per second. Since most AI-generated videos don't really make the cut anyways, this way you can iterate faster. But you do need to upscale the ones you want to keep in order to use them. So remember to save some credits for upscaling. 4-second video costs another 4 credits to upscale. I'm really impressed with the consistency of the character on the first try. The facial features, hairstyle, clothing, and even the makeup are exactly like my reference image. Her face looks like just how I would imagine, even from a totally different angle. Overall, the video followed my prompt pretty well, but honestly, I'm not sure if mentioning the camera did anything special for the quality. And yeah, this is definitely not a low angle shot. Also, aside from the zoom out, there wasn't much subtle movements or expression happening, and I'm pretty sure she's pretending to read. So let's tweak it a bit. We can click re-edit to send the same prompt and reference image back to regenerate or edit the prompt. Once again, the character is super consistent with the reference image I provided, so the consistency is definitely impressive. But there's a big issue. The video quality is still pretty blurry even in the upscale version. It's just not as sharp or realistic compared to what we see with other advanced models like Clean or Minimax. Maybe the quality model would fix that? I can't say for sure since I don't have access to it, but this is definitely something they could improve over time. If you want really high quality result, you may want to run the video through upscaling AI tools like Topaz. And also, she's clearly not reading a book here. I mean, should we be worried that AI think this is how reading works? In this example, you can see how Vidu's dedication to maintaining the consistency of the character's design to the details. Even though the prompts specify a purple sweater, the results still show the off-shoulder color in white that we bracketed in our reference image. To successfully change the clothing, we'll need to reference an even smaller part of the image, maybe just her face. This way, we can switch up the outfit while maintaining the facial consistency. Here are some other results I've tried. Do you think they look like the same person in all these different scenarios? I also tried adding a male character to see if the AI would mix up the features, since some tools apply the character consistency to everyone on the image. Luckily, it kept the trait where they belong on the girl, not the guy. But interestingly, I prompted for a Caucasian man on all of the instances above, and every time it gave me an Asian man. Then I tried a blonde woman. We've got two white characters. It's almost like Vidu has some very specific ideas about who should be dating whom. We can also try using a female reference to a male character, but I'm not sure what would be the use case. For realistic styles, Vidu does a great job maintaining perfect facial and clothing consistency with the reference image, but it sometimes struggles with anatomically correct movements, and occasional morphing can happen. With a few more tries, you can get some natural results, but be prepared to toss out quite a few before you find the right ones. I also want to try this character I created on Midjourney with very specific facial features and clothing details. She has brown curly hair, freckles on her face, and a unique yellow dress with fringe over a white top. Also, she has butterflies flying around her. First, I tried with referencing the whole picture to test on the consistency, and for the first few generations, I'm very impressed by the consistency of the characters again. It not only maintains the same facial feature and hairstyle, even the details of the dress and the colors are consistent. Also, the AI even include the butterflies fluttering around her in the scene with dynamic movement, and not just including them in a static situation. This shows that the AI can logically guess what the butterflies would behave around a character like this. Make sure to set the style at the end of your prompt to maintain consistency for your animation. If you forget, you might end up with the realistic results instead. On the plus side, this also means that you can easily switch up the character style whenever you want. To change her outfit, we can also just select her face and hair, and try changing her clothes.
For this one, we just added some Christmas vibes to her outfit. In this swimsuit example, I only selected her face and hair down to the shoulders, which is why her hair appears shorter than in the reference image. But overall, the face stayed consistent, and I'm impressed that it even made her hair look damn to match the beach setting. You can also use animals as reference characters and get fairly consistent results. Overall, the consistency of the animated character is pretty impressive, though occasional morphing and awkward anatomical movements still happen. In Vidu's official commercial, one interesting use case is using the reference subject for your merchandise. So I decided to put it to the test. I chose a pink Coach bag with the word Coach written twice on it, something I knew would be challenging, as AI tools often struggle to maintain text integrity in images or videos. After several tests, I found that Vidu did a great job keeping the overall shape and look of the bag, but the text often came out unclear or misspelled. The color was also off, usually appearing darker than the original, and the texture shifted from the canvas material to leather. Still, considering that Vidu is the only AI generator I know that can achieve this level of consistency for product in video, I'm still pretty impressed. I also tried generating a pink Stanley cup, but once again, the color was off, though the shape stayed true to the original. It struggled to replicate the Stanley cup logo as well, and the scene felt somewhat artificial, with the light and shadows not looking very realistic. Then I tested it with Croc sandals here. Although the crocodile logo didn't come through clearly in the video, the overall structure and the look of the shoes were preserved. If we could just squint our eyes and overlook the details, this video has some great potential as a pretty eye-catching commercial. Another issue is that it's hard to control the size of the product when you put it in the environment with other subjects. Like, this bed is definitely too small for this dog. It likely takes a lot of detailed prompt instructions and trial and error to get the size that just right. Overall, the current generation gives you a good idea of the product, but you might still need to do some visual manipulation to make the video truly usable. So, what do you think about Vidu's reference to video feature? Are you impressed, or do you think it could use some improvement? Let me know in the comments below. And check out my other videos for more fun AI applications. I'll see you in the next one.